those non-tech people also need to build the application they want to use. View ID is actually what view you want to see.
I totally agree. Why hasn't anyone done this yet?
Why? I don't know.
Why? Hey, so today I'm talking to Bieber. Is that your name? Bieber?
Yeah, it's my English name. And cool. I'm a big fan of Justin Bieber.
Oh, awesome. Okay. Makes sense. Me too. So super nice to meet you. The moment that I saw what you were building, like, it instantly clicked for me. It solves a problem that I've had a lot in the past. And I also saw that it's open source. So yeah, can you just tell me, like, what was the problem, the frustration that you had that led you to building Teable?
Okay, thank you. Very nice to meet you, James. And we built Teable because we think no-code tool is pretty good. It's pretty cool. But when we build our application on top of no-code tool, we find in this market, we don't have a good performance tools that can use it to build a large scale application. So we decided to make our own version of, you kind of like, the AirTable alternative. So we just start do this because we are experienced, and we've done the similar things before. And this time we want to make it public to the open source, and we want more people to use it, and we want to help more the people to do it.
That's awesome. That's really awesome. So actually, I think the best way to explain is probably just to demo it. So let's have a look.
Okay. I want to show you a scenario, and I share my screen now. Oh, what you see, this site is Teable's template center. This is a very simple the CMS site. You can click the template. There is a markdown article here and a cover. This site is actually built on top of Teable with Next.js and deployed on Brazil. Mm-hmm. And why I'm gonna happy to show you this, because I'm just spend a couple of hours to build the whole things. So this is the good demo that I think what can no-code tools help people build things. So I want to show you my code. Okay, as you can see, this is the table on Teable behind the template site. You can see there is a name, text, ID, and the favorite, cover, description, creator, and something. This is our operation center. This is a private space.
Oh, okay. This is your private database, right?
Yes, it's my private.
Okay. So in order to make this, a new user would just go to Teable, create a new sheet.
If you are a new user and if you want to build an application, maybe you want to build your database first. So if you are a new user, when you register your account, maybe you will come to this maybe an empty page, and you just click here, create a base, and then you can create a base from scratch or from template.
Cool.
We start create from scratch.
Okay,
this is the empty base, and in the base you can create blank table. Okay, we get into the blank table, and we have three default columns for name, count, status, and you can have anything here.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the number field, and the status you can select. Yeah, this is a basic simple demo of a simple base. And you can just to build your structure or database schema, click this plus, and you can add field. And here is the types we support for building your application. You can see we have text, the basic text and number, a selector, multiply selector, users, and so on. That is very useful for formula and the do-way link roll-up. And also you can look up to other table. This is a high level function.
And so all of these columns, when you add a column, you're modifying the schema of a Postgres table.
Yes.
Cool.
So what you see here, what you see about this table is actually is a Postgres table behind it. And so if you are a programmer or you're just learning to build something on database, you can click here, the API button. And here is a Postgres connection button. You can see you could just create a database connection, and you can use other tools like Table Plus, or something else to connect it to the database, and you will see the table just in Postgres.
That's amazing.
The template center table is actually very simple, because there is no relationship and no the advanced field. It's just for something content, and this is very useful. You can upload your image here, and you can preview here. So I'm gonna show you how we manage your template site. Click the public view. Oh, I wanna show what is the view in Teable.
Right.
It's also pretty simple because it's kind of like the database view. So you can create different filtering, sorting, or group options between different views. So this pending view, we add a filter about if this template launched. So you can see we have three templates we are just preparing, and it didn't launch. Click the public view, and those templates is what exactly you see. Just now in our template site. When we drag this record to adjust the order, you may see the template site is the order is also changed. Let me change to that page. Remove the sales CRM to the second order, and we refresh the page and see what's gonna happen. Yeah, it's in the second.
Let's see. Ah.
So it's very easy to manage your data, and all of this is what you see is what you get. That's why I love the no code tool. And maybe you guys are curious how to build this website, and you think you might have to write tons of code. Actually, I can show you how I get this. Let me find my VS Code. Okay. This project is a standard NextJS project. I just create it use the simple command line create a next app to create it. Let me check out the homepage. Homepage. Okay. Here is our homepage.
Are we loading the content client side or server side?
Actually, it's server side because I use the Next.js 14, and it's have a feature about app directory. You put your code here. All of this page are server side rendering. I think,
Oh, that's really useful.
So, yes, this page can be indexed by the Google, by the search engine, because it's server-side rendering. Oh, actually, it's called server-side component in the latest
Server-side
React 18.
component. I never know what to call
they call it SRC, server SSC maybe. So you can see this component is it's a React component, but we can use the await function here. This is async component. That is a new feature. So this is the function that how I make API requests. And I can explain you what I do here. You can see here, this is not important. This is just a type definition. Let me see it here. This is the ID map. That's very useful because you can see those strings. This string are the field ID in the table. So we give every single column ID. We call it field ID. You see, this is the name field. You can double click this name field, check out the field ID at the system info. Here is the ID. Yeah.
So is that
So for
the Postgres column header, column name?
Postgres column name is this name, DB name. This ID is just for Teable. It's
Oh, got it.
make me convenient to assist the
Yeah,
data.
got it.
And we created map so we can easy to assist our name field description and these fields we need. And then we just to going to start our request. Look at here. This is a simple GET request. And you should use the table ID, view ID, and the token. So what is the table ID? The table ID is just here you can see this is the table ID. Every single table ID is you can see assist your table. And the view ID is actually what view you want to see. And this token is for your personal assist token. You can generate your token here on the bottom left. You click your avatar, and you can see here. It's a assist token button.
Got it.
Click it. You can create a new token.
Cool.
Okay, and you can name your token and set the scope permission here. Okay, once you've done this, you can get a string that is your token. And go back here, and I use the ENV to store this ID and tokens, so I can change it easily. And here we have view of our params about what we need and what type of field key and what is the view. So after this fetch, we just get a response, and this response go to this function. That is just a single map function. We did done anything magic. That is pretty simple. Those all my code actually.
So the majority of your code is actually just the schema of the table.
Yes. So we can use this data to render the page. And this is some HTML code that is not important.
Awesome. Great. Do you have this on GitHub as well?
I think I'm not published this, but after this video, I am gonna publish it.
I'll put the link to that repo in the description of this video.
Okay, that's cool.
Cool. So that's the demo. I mean, it's pretty impressive what you can do. I can think of a lot of places where I would like to use this myself. Hopefully some more demos we can do in the future. So far, I see like you've got all the basics. What about like future features? Is there stuff that you're really excited to get to?
Yes, we have tons of features to develop. And I think the one thing we want to do is to bridge the gap between the non-tech users and the developers. What I showed you just now is how Teable can help developers to easily build their application. But another part about the no-code, we think those non-tech people should also need to build the application they want to use. And those application is not toy application. Maybe they can use it for a very important scenario and in their business. So we think we can just bring those two paths together. Why this is important? Because we have lots of no-code tools that allow people, the non-tech people, to build their tools. But when they reach to the tools, the edge, what they can do on this platform, they have nothing to do with that. They can't do anything about to build what they want. This time, we need the tech people to help them to build more powerful function on their app. But not to build a whole new application to replace that thing they've done before. But now we don't have the tool that can easily bring two part of people together. I think if those people can do what they good at and work together, that is be very, very useful for the efficiency, and we can build things quickly and more powerful.
I totally agree. Why hasn't anyone done this yet?
Why?
That's
I don't know.
why. Cool. And how has it been building an open source company in China? Is there a great ecosystem over there?
No, we build open source software in China is because we are Chinese. And I think China has so many talented engineers. That is true. But I think the open source community is better to go to the global market. It's not just in China. So at the first day, we think we should build a globalizational product. Yeah.
Cool. So you've been seeing a lot of international interest in your product after open sourcing it.
Yes.
That's awesome. Cool. Well, that's probably how I found it. Now, I think I have one more question. So there's a feature, as I've been kind of looking at your product, there's one feature where I'm thinking like, oh, if I just had this one thing, this would be completely killer. Do you have any idea what feature I'm thinking of? But it would be really, really awesome.
Actually, it's one feature that Teable is built on top of Postgres. The Postgres is a key feature, I think.
What about like the future?
Oh, okay, you mean the future. I think future, you can imagine it a scenario that people like to use Teable, people work on Teable every day, their data is on Teable. In that case, people not just want their data stored in the database. They want retrieve the data wisely or smart. And we can use the AI, the large language model capability to build the RAG system on it.
Oh, cool.
And this is not required for any technical skill.
Yeah.
People can just communicate with the database, and everything, every data, everything about him, about his company is on the database. All their business run on the database. The data is the newest about what they do. So AI can assist those data and output what they want. Maybe some suggestion, maybe some curious questions or data analytics and so on. So this tool will be more powerful than what we see now.
Oh, that's huge, actually. That makes me pretty excited. Actually, I was wondering, have you considered creating something like Teable Auth so that people can create an authentication system on their website using Teable?
I think it's cool because I've read about story about Supabase. Supabase
Yeah.
has the very good Auth SDK and for developers, and it gives he so much traffic and the project's growing fast. It's a good question, and we've thought it before, but I think we could just try it.
I ask because, I've used Supabase Auth and I've used Firebase Auth and I've used Firebase Auth integrated with Clerk, and there's so many solutions, but I still think the perfect solution is just not there yet. I like using row level security. I like that a lot for Supabase, and then I like Firebase rules for Firebase. But I think what you're doing is you're just creating something that's like so much easier to use. So just a thought. You don't have to do
That's
it because I
the
said so.
perfect suggestion.
I was just wondering because I'm already going to be using your software, and if you're planning to build in some authentication there as well, then I can make entire products basically just using Teable and Next.js, or even just single page application and then Teable as the back end.
Yeah, that's
So.
interesting. And I think we should talk the detail later. And I will come to you.
Awesome, cool. Well, thanks so much for showing us. And yeah, I hope a lot of people see this and they realize that making a backend database for their application, that when they're making a backend database for the application, they don't have to choose between it being something that's performance or something that has like a nice interface that's easy to use. They can have both.
Thank you.
Cool.